The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters and restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. I'd like to thank all of you today who have come here to offer your condolences to the family and to pay respect. Say goodbye to William Carnegie Balamaci. He was related not to Andrew Carnegie. I don't know if he was related to Dale, but he certainly was his prime apostle. Bill was, I'm sorry to say, I should be ashamed to say as the priest, but he was the peacemaker. People often say to me, oh, you're so fortunate, you're a son of the parish, and you know people, and you can talk about them and say things. Well, I'll tell you something. I appreciate it as a blessing for weddings, and for baptisms, and for happy occasions. But it's very, very difficult for funerals. When you bury the young, Scottish poet John Donne, who said, no man is an island of itself. Any man's death diminishes me because I am involved in mankind, and therefore never send to know for whom the bell tolls. It tolls for thee. This funeral, the bell tolls. So interconnected. He had that in his mind. He thought of that. Who's president, vice president, secretary, chief cook and bottle washer of the parish council. Not only was he the president, but if he had to speak or not, he did it. Did a lot of work behind the scenes that we never knew about. Executive committee, long-range planning committee, the co-founder and the co-chairman of the festival, our festival that started 40 years ago that seems so much a part of us today, that we say, oh, the festival is just a necessity to the point that we even have two of them now. He and Bob Nicola, his other bosom buddy, started 40 years ago, and everybody was saying, are you crazy? Who's going to do all this work? Well, here we are, and so much a part of us. He started the youth talent shows, if you remember. If you played a musical instrument, or if you had some musical ability, you were required to get up on that stage at the talent show. And Bill wanted to show off, not himself, he wanted to show off the talent of the kids in the community. He loved them, and he encouraged them. He was an officer and a very active member of the society, for sure. He was president, vice president, and very active in the force, the Federation of Orthodox Churches of Connecticut. And this guy worked a full-time job. He was an associate and a partner with his mentor, Nicholas Iannulli, for years in insurance planning. He did all this and did all of this behind the scenes. He was, I have other things. He faithfully attended the Bible class with him in the last few years. And he served our country in the Sea Gov Flag and in the reserves, became a lieutenant colonel. He was very active in the armed forces in those days, but during the Vietnam War, he was especially active. I don't believe he ever went overseas, but he was here. And he helped so many of us in that. During the draft, he helped many of us. A devoted father, brother, grandfather, devoted to everyone, not just to the church and his family, but he would always find a good word to say. And he would say, if you can't say something good, don't say it at all. And that was the motto that he lived by. He really was a disciple of Dale Carnegie, how to win friends and influence people. He won friends and he influenced a lot of people. And I'll tell you, he never came empty-handed. Wherever he went, he was always sure to bring cookies, cakes, fruit, something, never coming empty. And in this, he reminds me so much of two of his forebears. His paternal grandmother, Eulogia Balamaci, who would work tirelessly for the church. She was so devoted, working for the church, always thinking of new things to do, how to help the ladies' auxiliary grow, to make money for the church and get support. He had that. But he also had the meekness and tenderness and devotion of his maternal grandfather, Palomita, Sherry, had both sides in him. Just an aside, Palomita, Dimitri Sherry, would be at the candlestick, very, very involved with the church. And in the old days, we used to give a flower up for the name days. You remember? What was your name day? You got a carnation. And he would keep track, he had a book, and he would say to me, we're still winning. I said, who's still winning? There's more Dimitris than Georges. Now, who names your kid Dimitri or George today, buddy? There were 37 Dimitris and 33 Georges. Imagine, besides all the Nicks, the Nicholases, and all those other names. Billy had that kind of gusto, that kind of humor, that kind of tenderness, and he could be tough. There were times when he was tough. that should have been so much enjoyed now at this age. You'd want to get into your 80s at least, spend some time with my kids and my family. We don't lose Billy today. We lost him a few years ago. He wasn't the same person we know. But the thing that gives us hope, and that's why we're here today, is because we have to believe in what he believed in, the resurrection, that there is a better place, that this is not the end, that he's going to be in a place where he's going to meet again all his relatives and all his friends and all those who have gone before in the St. Dimitri parish that's in heaven. He's well deserving of that. I don't think there's any question. Somebody said to me, well, we're going. I said, yeah, we're all going, but the question is, where are we going? We hope that everyone ends up in heaven. And I don't think there's any question that Bill is there in paradise. He received Holy Communion last month when I went. He knew what he was doing. I asked him, you want to receive communion? And he said, yes, please. So he realized that he was taking the body and blood of Christ. And just the afternoon before he died, that Sunday afternoon, we went to the hospital, and I blessed him. He was semi-conscious, but when I started saying the Lord's Prayer, he opened his eyes. He could hear. He knew. And he wanted to pray with me. And he did. He did. And his soul departed on Monday, right after that. We can say, follow him. We're so sorry that he's gone. But what a blessing for him. This is a blessing. Because we all look forward to the heavenly kingdom. And we go to a place where there's no pain, or sorrow, or sighing, or suffering, but only a beautiful, blissful life that has no end. And for that, we pray for Billy, for the Lord to forgive him whatever he's done. Traditionally, in our Orthodox Catholic Church, we pray for forgiveness. We pray for forgiveness of the soul of the person departed. We ask him for forgiveness because it's his last night in our presence in the church. We ask for his forgiveness if we've offended him, and we forgive him for any offense that he has committed against us. May the Lord hear our prayer and forgive him and accept him into his heavenly kingdom. Always now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Please rise. Established with the saints, who from the ages have been pleasing to you, and that his body be returned to the elements. May the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, who gave to his holy disciples and apostles the divine command to retain and forgive the sins of those fallen, and to us who have received the power to do likewise from them, forgive you all which you have transgressed in this earth, your life voluntarily and involuntarily, now and ever, and into ages of ages. Amen.
For you are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your servant, Basilius William, who has fallen asleep, O Christ our God. And we offer glory to you together with your Father, who is without beginning, in your all holy, good, and life creating spirit, now and forever, and into the ages of ages. Amen.
Purify me with hyssop until I am clean. Wash me until I am whiter than snow. Grant eternal repose and blessed sleep, O Lord, to the soul of your servant, our brother, who in the rescue of us fallen asleep. And make his memory to be eternal.
Son, be of the Lord, who are Thank you.